lost my way, stumble around all day. I try to stand up straight, but then I tumble down.
Hi, and welcome to Talking with Giants. I'm your host, Scott Schilling. Really glad to have you here today. This is going to be a fun show, I can tell you that for a fact. Now, I like to start these all the exact same way with my pregame prayer, so here goes. Lord, allow the words we share here today to positively impact 100% of the lives of the audience in one way, shape, or form. Only you know who you sent here to hear this message. Allow us to do the best we can to share that message, be a vehicle, and of service to you. See, that's all we can ever control is a high intention and a low attachment. A high intention of imparting something good and a low attachment as to what that means to you personally or what that nugget is. There's going to be plenty through our time today. In fact, before we get started, I think we need to celebrate a little bit. Now, we just had to start that way because my guest today authored that song with his group Cool and the Gang back in the day. Sir Earl Toon, so great to have you. Now, Sir Earl achieved his notoriety by playing with multi-platinum band Cool and the Gang, the height of worldwide fame, Penn Celebration, Ladies Night, which I have the album to here for my lovely wife to get her have Earl sign it today. The group earned 2 Grammys, 7 American Music Awards, 25 top 10 R&B hits, 31 gold and platinum albums. He's the proud son of Lois and the Reverend Early Eugene Moon. Father was a soul R&B and gospel recording artist. That had to lay a little on your heart from that side. Proudly embraces his heritage, coming out of Brooklyn as a bouncing baby boy. Passionately speaks lovingly about coming from Brooklyn. Now, in the fall of 2014, Sir Earl Toon released his first solo, The Old Rugged Cross. We're going to talk about more of that at the end. 2016 was honored as part of the prestigious Introduction Recording Academy's Class of 2016 Grammy Hall of Fame. Man, I could keep on and on. The accolades are here. Earl, thanks for being with us, man.
Scott, it's my pleasure being here to see you.
You know, it's always so much fun when we come together.
Yes.
It's we've been friends for a long time now, and you know, the good that you've been doing around North Texas, one of the things that we keep on doing is running into each other at charity events.
Yes.
And I love your heart and everything that you're working to do here in North Texas alone. Give a kid a coat, hands down, love for kids, focus on the future. If I had known Snowball Express, man, where's that heart come from, man?
Well, that's just some of them. Well, from my mom and my dad, but because of the prayers and well wishes of others. My mom died when I was 4 years old, and my grandmother raised me. So she instilled with my great-grandmother and great-grandfather that old-time religion. And you can't go but so far without realizing just how great thou art. So it keeps me centered, and no mistakes. I'm not perfect. I don't have a hell over my head. But because of God's grace is one of the reasons why I'm here now and the things that I've accomplished.
Very, very neat. Now, I know you had to have a bunch. What was it like being with Cool and the Gang?
Wonderful, wonderful. As I always says, and Cool will tell you, that it came from me. Once a gang member, always a gang member. And I'm telling you right now that it was every week in and month out and year in and year out, it was truly a celebration. And sometimes, of course, more than others. But I'm going to tell you, man, we were not lucky. We were truly given, first, we were anointed, all of the guys. But God allowed us to express ourselves through music. And people say, well, wait a minute now. God allowed you to do funk music, R&B music, pop music. Well, when I wrote Yahoo! Celebrate good times. Come on, we're going to celebrate your party with you. Celebration. That could only come from the grace of God. And they're still dancing to it today. So, yeah.
That was one of the, when we first met, that's how our conversation actually started. I think my wife, Peggy,
yes.
The beautiful Miss Peggy.
I love. Sis, how are you? Miss you.
Just said, man, that's one of my all-time favorite songs. And it just started a connection with us. And
yes.
We don't see each other all that often, but when we do, it's always special.
No, but see, the thing is that like iron sharpens iron, man sharpens man. And whenever we do see each other, you have no idea. You give me, you uplift me, and people say I uplift them. We uplift each other, and the things that you have done and that you are doing, is also amazing. And it just reminds me that I'm not out here alone. And knowing men such as yourself and women that are on the front line of giving back, and not only for our children, for the elders, for the veterans, the homeless, the battered women, the bullied kids, the animals, the planet. Man, you're a blessing to me, and I thank God for you.
Well, thank you. I'm honored. I'm honored. From the first day we met, I was actually looking back at some emails today to see how long. It's been a long time. I mean, it's really,
yes,
neat. So when you were in that collaboration mode where you're really working with Cool and the Gang and writing songs, and what's that process like? I mean, does everybody just kind of throw out a nugget, or does somebody take a lead in the area? What's
that
like?
You know what? It's the thing that, especially with myself, Yemir Diodato, George Brown, Ronald Bell, Cool, DT, Amir, Spike, JT. You got to understand. It's Charles Smith. I mean, everyone contribute more or less. Lyrically, melodically, through arrangement, production. It was the thing that you're looking and working towards something that the people, it wasn't just about selling records, it was about putting something out that someone would truly enjoy. Someone would dance to, someone would drive to work to, drive home to, someone would to be able to dance to passionately. Some music to make love to, some music to believe or not to, just have a good time, a yahoo of a time. What I'm saying to you is that it wasn't just myself. And being the only protege of Otis Blackwell, the man that wrote the biggest songs for Elvis Presley, Don't Be Cruel, or Shook Up, Return to Sender. I mean, he took me under his wing, and the techniques that he's taught me helped me to do those songs, like Ladies Night, Get Down on It Too Hard, and things like that. But if it wasn't with the guys, for the guys, I should say, also with me, none of this would have been the way that it was. And I'm
sure.
Gonna tell you something. It was all for one and one for all.
That's cool.
You know, yeah.
That's cool. So who are your influences? Who touched your heart?
Oh, my mom.
Nice.
Even when she, even though she left too soon, I feel, but. They said that God truly wanted an angel right here on earth, because not because she was beautiful, because most will say my mom being beautiful or their mom being beautiful. No, but they said the elders love her, the young people loved her. She was good to the bone, and I couldn't understand, because Grandma said that, hey, when you do right, God, you'll live a long life. And that bothered me at first, but she inspired me to know that when I seen that smile of hers, and I was called the pumpkin, that the things that I did to make her proud did something for me. My grandmother, my dad, early Eugene Toon, like Otis Blackwell, Scott, like you. I mean, really, people I just met this week from an ad agency I did something with, Advice Local, and it was Rocks Digital. I mean, people that you would say, well, who are they? I mean, I promise you, Carla Harrell, for the Rhinestone Artist and what she's done to help, and also co-founder with me with Give a Kid a Coat. I can go on and on of people, unbelievable people that have, in my life, just given me something to strive for, to better myself with and for. And I want to thank each and every one of you, because without you, wouldn't be no me. First, God's grace. and his favor. But with you, with his anointing me and your expertise and your brilliance and your anointing, that's the reason why YMO, yours, mine, and ours, continues and will flourish, will be a part of the, if you will, the fabric of America soon.
Yeah, we're going to talk about YMO in just a second. But one of the things I want you to know, you are actually in my Y video from our night together at the Night of Superstars when you were walking a young lady down the aisle, making her feel tremendously special.
Really?
I got a picture of that. And I actually have that in my Y video that I show from stage, why I do what I do, cool friends like you.
Oh, see? Thank you. That is so heartfelt. Thank you. And the reason why I strive to do the best I can, more than even for myself, but not about me, for others, because my grandmother would say, son, the good you do, I'll come back home to you. She didn't say it wouldn't, and she said, and it don't cost very much. So she, in other words, she was saying, it wasn't that it wouldn't cost you anything, be it that it's time or money or whatever, but when you do something for others, truly, it's always, you'll get it back, regardless if you see it directly to you, even your loved ones. If they get it, then it's something done well-deserved.
So let's talk a little bit about YMO, yours, yes. Mine, and ours.
Yes.
Tell me about the vision of what you're working to accomplish through that.
YMO truly, outside and first and foremost, being yours, mine and ours, is being yours, God's first, mine and ours. If we would all just try, regardless of what, how old, young, rich or poor, how black, white, red, I don't care if you're blue, green, regardless of what religion, regardless of what, be it you politically, Democrat, Republican, left wing, right wing, conservative, regardless of, to me, respectfully, it's if we would extend kindness and love and work and honor each other, even with our differences, and what might be right for you more so may not be right for me, but if, in fact, I truly believe that what we do, this planet, is yours, mine, and ours, then let's love it as so and love each other so. And that's what I'm putting through the music. I want it to be through the merchandise, through the other things. It's yours, mine, and ours.
So it's a platform, really, to bring people together.
Like sitting at the table. Who doesn't love a wonderful meal?
Mm-hmm.
When grandma or mom would fix the meals, when folks come in, and even if you were to invite a stranger, they become family. They'll be able, in other words, we start sharing ideas, even at an impasse. But we'll know how you're feeling, how I'm feeling. And it's not nothing, and that's the reason why it saddens me when I hear of such destruction and people doing things on the planet the way that they are now, instead of us knowing that mankind, this is our home. This is what we are. What are we doing? So through the music, look, I'm not reinventing the wheel. But YMO wants the ride to be a little smooth. I want to take you on a ride through the music, be it pop music, rock and roll, be it jazz, be it blues, inspirational. But still through it all, what's going to be woven is that which is inspiring, inspirational to say, love your neighbor as you love thyself.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Treat your children with respect. Honor your wife. Honor your husband. Love your friends. Yeah, we're not perfect. I may drop the ball. But even if I'm a bad person, really, pray for me and allow God to work for me. And you could feed me like mom said when grandma with a long-handled spoon. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. I know that Peggy and I came to an event. I don't recall what the event was, but by surprise, you were playing there. You had put together a band of young players, and you were up there playing with them. And it was just so much fun. I don't even remember what the event was now, but it was just fun. And to see your wisdom and guidance, that had to be a thrill for all the artists that were up there.
I hear that all the time, but what they don't understand, it's even more so a thrill for me. Do you know, as much as I could ever teach them, they're teaching me? And that's how wonderful, that's how great thou art, that's how unbelievable God is, that I told the kids this Thursday. I had about 16 kids from a company called Next Generation pro dancers or professional dancers. And Becky, which is the overseer of them, we had kids from this high, I promise you, to maybe 19 years old. And they performed with me, and I wanted them to because the experience, they have no idea. They thought, and I heard them say, and to others, that they were so, like, they felt so inspired. They don't know. They were inspiration to me because I let them know there's something that they have that I don't have. And that's why it's so important that I do whatever I can for them. And they looked at me like, what? And I said, youth. You are youth. You are me tomorrow. Yesterday's, I'm looking forward for you to make things better in this world. You. Oh my gosh, let me take off my glasses. Because I want everyone to see. I want to tell you this right in the camera. In your community, regardless of where you are, your children are the most important things that it is on this planet. Because I wished you to live the same amount of years you lived already, to be 100 to 200 years old. But guess what? Who's going to be there to help you, to take care of you, to honor you? Instill in them that. Help them, support them in every way. I needed for that to be said.
No, that's the way this show rolls. Very rarely does it come the way that on the notes, for sure. No, I totally agree with you. One of the things, and I think it's part of our friendship in our knowing each other and in our time together that we've spent, is there's no pretense. There's, you know, it's just, it's people coming together with a common desire to make the planet a better place. I said something to somebody one time. I said, you know, we were talking about some world issue that was just whacked out. And I said, can't we just all get along? And he goes, nope, we're just not built that way. Oh. And I said, man, I refuse to accept that.
See, I can't do anything without, here's where YMO is also.
Yeah.
I can't do nothing without God's grace, without his favor, his blessings, his anointing. Again, I can't do nothing without your expertise and your brilliance and your anointing. So with that being said, again, yours, mine, and ours, there are a lot of things that we won't see eye to eye. But that's what makes it so beautiful, that we, like a flower arrangement. Can you imagine that there were only roses or daisies or only greenery? What about the blues, the reds? Because I tell you, if we would just know that, if we just try, and sometimes it may be a bit much to take at times, but if we would just try, and as a whole, I promise you, even those people that are so reluctant to change will say, well, maybe just try a little bit of it. Because even if it doesn't taste good to you, it may be better for you than you could ever know, sir.
Yeah, the service part I know is tremendously rewarding. I know you do it a lot with kids.
Yeah.
Although when we're filming this, we're in the heat of summer. But the good news is this will be evergreen and people will see it at the right time. I want to talk a little bit about Give a Kid a Coat.
Yes.
Just what a great project.
The reason why this project was the brainchild actually came to me was that Miss Carla Harrell was going to work one morning, and I got a call from her. She said, you won't believe what I saw. I saw a little girl shivering with a tiny, tiny jacket. It was like a thin little jacket going to school, and the wind was blowing, and it was cold. It was icy, and she said, I felt so bad. I said, where was this? She told me the place, and I said, well, maybe we should go there after if you want to. She said, I don't know. I said, yes, let's go. And you know what? She didn't want to reluctantly, but because that's how she is. But it just bothered. I said, if it bothers you that much, let's do that. Well, we went. We spoke with the principal. He said to me, he said, Mr. Toon, I got to tell you, there's a lot of kids here that don't like that. I said, well, he says, well, some of the parents, they're proud and some of them hardworking parents, but they just don't have right now. We can't do, and I'm like, what? So we raised, I think, close to 200 coats. myself and she. It cost a pretty penny. I said, look, we got to find another way to do this. So we started. They already had coats for kids. So we said, no. So it came to me, give a kid a coat. Mm-hmm. And we put that together. And this year, this was 3 years ago, this year, we came up with over 1,500 coats we gave to the DISD, last year to the RISD. So, and we want to make my thing this year, and I know it sounds crazy, I want to like triple that. I want to do like 5,000 coats if I can, because I found out, Scott, that there are over 5,000 kids almost in Dallas alone that are homeless, that people don't realize.
Yeah, that we need to help. One of the things that I actually... in one of my other businesses, I have an Amazon business, and what I found was a liquidator that was liquidating sweat clothes and things like that, mm-hmm. and I bought some. And I know it's too hot for them right now, but the point is there are many people trying to get rid of things that we can, I'd love to help you with
this. Yes, I would.
But I'm just saying, now's the time because it's hot. People are getting rid of things.
Absolutely.
Now would be the time to plant the seeds.
Well, I
to
need
see
one
how
of the
we
things
can come
that,
into the fall.
One of the things I want you to know, and I say this respectfully because I can't speak for her, but I can speak of knowing her spirit and heart, Miss Harrell, is that we cherish, we embrace those that can help us, and we're transparent to give back to others. I mean, there are people that if it wasn't for Dwayne McCollum and that with Mr. Kevin Weaver and that with Mr. Rainey Rogers and those people for Dr. Eleanor Sullivan and I can name on and on. If I'm forgetting names, please forgive me. Those that have helped, you know, Richard Anastasi, and I can go on, Michael Fant. I'm talking about wonderful people that have given of their time and services to help us to give back to these kids. And there's so many other names. As a matter of fact, I would love to send them to you because I don't want no one to be left out. But these are such unbelievable people, and I thank God for them all. And you know what? We welcome you and anyone else that you can help us to do the things that we need to do. That's the reason why the old Rugged Cross that I was doing, which was given consideration last year for a Grammy, and the only reason why I didn't campaign for it because it was a demo, and I wanted to give God my first fruit. And so, but we'll do it. We're doing it again, but the long version, because that's only half of the song. But I can't say all the proceeds, but most of those proceeds, because they take 30% of the top, are going back to the charities, nonprofit organizations, and not just ours. You got to understand there are others out there on the front line
right.
that are doing wonderful things, and I'm supporting them in every and any way that I can.
Well, we'll build a page on talkingwithgiants.com for Give a Kid a Coat and for you and for the song and anything that we can do to
God bless you,
lift
guys,
you up, God. Lift what's going on.
Thank you.
You know.
Thank you.
Jeez.
Thank you
anyway,
so
just.
Much.
I was sitting thinking about when I purchased those products, there was an opportunity. I would never use them. It wasn't that, I mean, I didn't buy them for me. I bought right. them for something. I didn't even know why I bought them, but obviously
That's
God
the
had,
spirit.
Had
oh,
you
yes.
in mind.
Yes.
So I'm really excited about sharing those with you, that you can use those
See,
in your program.
To make me Crap, I got to put my glasses on. I'm going to have to put my shades on. And everybody said, this man up here is boo-hooing.
So,
but I don't care. See, because that's the love of God. That's a godly love, y'all. I'm telling you, that's the love I'm talking about. And that's the love of giving our children, our elders. That's the love. Helping the homeless, the veterans. That's the love. Thank you, brother.
Yeah, so what I want to do is make sure, as we go out, we've still got a couple Woo. Of minutes to talk, but we're going to play a little bit of the old Rugged Cross. We want to make sure that people know where to get it, because again, the vast majority of the proceeds are going to support the worthy causes
yes.
you're involved in.
Yes.
So where can they get that? Where can they get
this? Oh, on Amazon, of course, .com, iTunes, Google Play, CD Baby, and like that. And they're putting, actually helping me with my website, Advice Local. And with the Rocks Digital folks there are helping me in the next few weeks to do that and get that, which I'd love to introduce you to. They are amazing people doing unbelievable things for the community. And smart business people, too, you understand?
Well, that's what it comes down to using. I'm involved. TWG, the entire project, talkingwithgiants.com, is really social entrepreneurialism. It's entrepreneurialism used to solve world problems.
Wow.
So it's how do we take the business minds and the people we know and the things we have to solve what normally are solved by nonprofits. Nonprofits are spending most of their time raising money, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
yes.
What if we could just do business? What if we could figure out how to do
sweet.
This? So would love to help you.
Well, you
in
know,
that.
I got to tell you this, though. That's the reason why I got to also thank Sabino, which is a friend of mine. They call him the cigar roller. Do you know what he has done for Give a Kid a Coat? He has made cigars that proceeds of the cigars that he makes.
Nice.
Believe it or not, every cigar that he sells goes to help Give a Kid a Coat. So you can't.
We'll put that on the site as well.
Oh, yes.
So we're winding down. We got our last 30 seconds here. I just want to say it's such an honor to have Sir Earl Toon here because of his heart, because of his desire to serve others. See, we all have the opportunity. It's a choice whether we take that opportunity. God gave us that opportunity. I want to thank you for being here. We're going to keep on bringing great guests. Listen to the old Rugged Cross. Take advantage of it. Go into charity.
Woo! Far away, stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the deep is in bands, for a world of lost sinners was slain. Even that old rugged cross stained with blood.
Hi, Scott Schilling here. A number of years ago, I met Guinness Book of World Records holder, world's fastest reader, Howard Berg. His ability to manage knowledge impressed me. With the amount of information available today and the pace with which it's coming at us, having the ability to read and remember that information is more critical every day. Howard told me that using his techniques, I could double my reading speed in just a few short hours. Initially, I wasn't sure, but if in fact Howard was right, it'd be the best $100 in a couple hours I ever spent. Then Howard made an irresistible offer. Learn it first. Double your reading speed in just a few hours, or you owe me nothing. Now, how can you go wrong? The results have been amazing. I asked Howard if he would pass along that same opportunity to our TWG audience. Emphatically, Howard said yes. To learn more, simply go to twgspeedreading.com. Watch a short introductory video, sign up for the webinar that best fits your schedule, and double your reading speed in just a few hours, or you pay nothing. Now that's a deal worth looking into. TWGSpeedReading.com.